You may start. There you go. Good luck. All right. What are you doing mainly? Are you a full-time content creator? I do a lot of content. Yes, I am. I would say, yeah, I'm a full-time content creator. Technically, yes. But I do not have a 9-to-5, if that's what you're asking. Oh, I don't see they started, Sag. I can't bet my 440 points on them. Hey, but you can bet the 440 points on the people in the finals, and it'll probably be like 450 points by then. I think I don't even remember how much Twitch gives you. It either gives you 10 points or it gives you 50 points. I know it's one or the other. But all right, normal Rakea. That was the most sus. Yeah, I do content. Hey. Hey, that's not sus though. That's not sus. Oh, I guess you meant like suspicious. Okay. I thought you meant sus. I was like, that's not sus. I'm betting 4 racks on the finals. Oh, also Leftover Shark. Sleeve Chief gifted you a sub while you weren't here. I recognized the name, of course. Come on now. Duo OnlyFans. Oh God no. Oh God no. OnlyFans for Yu-Gi-Oh! Only deck profiles. Yama, Shivara, Aruha, Trap. Yup. Checks out. Yeah, that's just game. Well, it's just game if the opponent doesn't have anything. The Unchained combo feels so broken if it goes through. Like, it's just so many interruptions. Like, you're reaching 6-7 off of every play. Only deck. Good looks to Sleeve Chief if they still here. No, they gifted it. I think it was a few days ago when they did that. But I remembered, and when I saw your name, had to bring it up. Only combos. OnlyFans makes sense for the post-nut Yu-Gi-Oh chat. The post-nut. Oh my gosh. Gotta get post-nut YGO up in here. He's actually in my video on Sunday. I have a video recorded with a post-nut Yu-Gi-Oh. They played in the match on Sunday. So that'll be a very good match to watch. Only grinding with the grinder. Stop. The whole deck is extenders, so annoying to play against. Unchained? Nah, I wouldn't say it's like annoying to play against. It's like fine. Just the end board is so much. The interruptions are just everywhere. Oh, thinking here. Oh, thinking on Sarama summon. Kind of sucks they had to start with Rakea. They're getting hit with Nib there. Okay. It's fine. Matrix has been playing Unchained for months now. When they get hit with Nib, they know what to do. Watch this. They're cooking. And they're not under Prosperity this turn either. They're cooking. Good old Walter Jewell. God, yes. Oh, Ash on the thrust. Dang, that actually hurts so much because Thrust would have played through that. They had Shyama Graveyard effect. Oh, that's so tough. And they're playing like 33 card or 43 cards. So they're playing over 40 by a good amount, which makes me think that there might be a disaster in their deck also, which helps play through Nib a lot. Being able to link off the opponent's monster. Set any cards still okay? Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't say set any card still okay. Like, set any card you still can play. But you really want an Unchained effect here. Otherwise, like, what are you doing? Are you popping an Imperm to summon the Shyama here? Like, sure. And then also, oh, they have Abomination's Prison set. Oh, you're crazy. Okay, there we go. Cool. Nice. Pop Imperm, yes. Well, I mean, yeah, if you had Imperm, yes, you'd pop Imperm and summon it. But, like, what are you actually doing from there, right? Like, what would you actually do from there? This, what we talking about? Oh, yeah. Just draw ball. Yeah, Ash on Thrust? Sure. Set Abomination's Prison. Shyama. Pop. Abomination's Prison. Yama. Summon. Summon. Easy. Easy. But I do wonder if they play Disaster, though, because they can't just, like, make DDD wave high King Caesar, that's it against Nib. Like, you do have to deal with this card, or, you know, are we going for a Griffin line? I don't know. I don't know what they want to do here, but I guess we will find out. Also, I want to peep what the other people were playing real quick. Just so that way we know. Because I know what the awkward one's playing. I actually know what they're playing. Yeah, I was going to say, right when I thought about it, I knew. Okay, and then they're playing against, it looked like a Runic Sprite deck. Pretty sure that's what it was. But okay, so we got like Runic Sprite versus Branded. And then we have Unchained in this blank 45 card deck. But alright, playing through Ash Nib with their 4 card combo. So, I wonder if the opponent will, yeah, if you have some issue type, thinking here, okay. I wonder if they're going to ask about slow playing here soon, because it feels like it's taking a while. Table 3 and DB Rated is playing some crazy tier build, like Resonator, Horus, tier shenanigans. Oh, God, yes. God, yes. Love decks like that. Decks like that are so cool. I just hope I never play against them at a tournament. Okay, so Prison summon Shavara, Yama summon Aruha, and then Pop Aruha. Aruha. I'm sorry, what? I'm not even gonna ask. I'm gonna assume that they accidentally pressed on summoning Aruha and they meant to just summon Sarama. Yeah, that's what they meant to do. Okay. They meant to summon Sarama, not Aruha. Okay. I was gonna say, there's no way they just went Yama, summon Aruha, pop Aruha, Aruha effect, summon Sarama from grave. I was like, huh? Obviously, that wouldn't even make sense why you would do that. So, okay, that's fine. Maybe you want to snack that replay if they clean. What do I know? Yeah, I have no idea. But I can't open another DB tab right now. I don't want my stream to lag. But hopefully I will catch them at some point. As long as they're high rated, of course. Because if they're not high rated, then it's not even worth watching, to be honest. I mean, the other Blackwing Dragon Synchro isn't bad in tier. Oh yeah, that card is crazy. That card says mill 5. Both 900 plus points. Oh god, yes. Anguish effect, link off, yup. Go up in the Soul of Rage. So through Nib, ending on DDD, Soul of Rage. That's pretty good. So, the thing is though, they only spent 2 cards. They stopped the trap card, they stopped some follow up. They don't have Yama in their graveyard, that obviously makes this a lot weaker. Yeah, I don't know. I guess we'll find out when we find out what deck they're playing. They are playing 45. Maybe it's just Dragon Link, though. Playing 45. I mean, that's like the most common deck number, though. I feel like Dragon Link. Oh, activate Wanted Poster. Okay, maybe Rescue Ace. Maybe. There's a lot of different things it could be at this point, to be honest. That doesn't show too much. Hand Traps plus Wanted Poster. Let's go to Spanish. Said, at what time will you start accepting post-PHNI January? I don't know what that is, so I have no idea. Whenever the set comes out, I guess, is when I'll probably start accepting it. Or maybe, like, right before it comes out. But that's, like, months away. So we'll find out when the time comes. Summon Black Witch by sending Angelica Ring. Okay, Infernoble, sure. Imperm on that. Summon Send. Set Snake Eye. Sure. And then, I was about to say, we'll probably go Battle Phase here to beat over Solar Rage. Or attempt to. But Matrix right now probably should go Solar Rage effect in the SP banish the set. Doesn't seem very good. Doesn't seem very good because This card does work with banished copies also. So it could go ahead and still attempt to draw. So I was going to say, yeah, you probably allow them to at least say end of main. And if they start playing, then that's what we want. But yeah, end of main, Soul of Rage. Matrix just casually played through Nib Ash while the opponent wasn't even unreasonable with the hand traps. Yeah, I mean, Unchained's crazy. But Nib also doesn't affect this deck, like, at all. So, yeah, Nib is very bad against this deck. A majority of the time, they're just playing through it. Now, when you have Nib plus another hand trap, then sure, you have decent chances. But did not work there. Not at all. Valiant Smashers is 2 weeks away. Anything in the making for that? Nope. Not a single thing. Honestly, I don't even know what comes out. If something new came out next weekend, I'd have no idea. Because I only paid attention up until YCS Richmond. I haven't paid attention to anything past that so far. But okay, yeah. SP banished the Sinful Spoils, the Wanted poster, out of their graveyard. Because if you banish this, they can banish, get a draw, then they have two blanks. So instead, they have left a card in their hand. Which, I mean, if they normal summon and then snake eye it away, it's probably not very good. Ogier would activate. Yeah, you'd have to activate it. Otherwise, you just have no value anyways. Yeah, so you submit defeat. Nice. We'll play on the opponent's side. Excited for the Calamity Lock, Centron in 2 weeks. That's going to be Raid post-support Copium. What hand trap do you think is good? What hand traps? I mean, Imperm, Veiler, Ash, Nib. Those are pretty good hand traps. There's also other hand traps that you could, like, side deck for more specific matchups, like Crow, Droll, Shifter. I mean, obviously, if your deck can main deck Shifter, then sure. Like, cool. But a lot of the time, for most decks, it's just like side deck Shifter. Oh god, yes, the classic lose game 1, game 2, go normal summon connector effect combo. Oh, does Matrix have a response to it? Does Matrix have a response? Do they have Ash Blossom? Do they have Imperm plus Ash Blossom? And they're thinking on which one to use on connector. So against Unchained, I mean. Oh. If they're going first, then Shifter's good. Otherwise, I mean, Ash, hope that you can stop them. Imperm, hold it for your turn on DDD. Now, you're still gonna have to play against a bunch of interruptions, but hopefully the deck can play through an interruption or two or three. I mean, you use Imperm for sure first to play around Talons. Yeah. You know what I mean. They could have had it, and they were just thinking about it. But that's, like, why you'd be thinking about it. Like, the Talons thing and everything like that. Mara and Joseph. I don't even know what Imperm and Nib. Yeah, they have Imperm and Nib and combo. Wait, was that combo? It was Rakea, Sarama, Abominal, right? That's not combo. It's like almost combo. Nib plus Imperm. Sheesh. Yeah, Nib plus Imperm. Very, very good. Very, very good. Link off now into a soul. Effect to go search. Okay. Huh? We thinking about stopping that. Okay. We could stop it. If we want to imperma-sold, we could just imperma-sold first effect. They extend with a monster. Sure, that makes second assault. Sure, that's fifth summon. Bam, drop Nib. But assault's going to search out Kashtira Riseheart. And then search out Kashtira Riseheart. That seems so bad, though. That's not even like follow-up. That's like searching a brick. I guess if you're just discarding it, then it's fine. I guess maybe we're just gonna, like, discard it off Oliver or something in our combo. But a soul dump four to go ahead and try to bring out the Ogier. And then Ogier effect the dump. They could set up Gearfreed with Oliver equipped and another equip spell. That would be Impermanib. It's very hard to set up though. And you'd probably get it with Impermanib before you set that up. And then you have to play through the Impermanib. Oh, also shout out to Rafa King 01 for the follow and Mitchy for President for the follow. Thank you, thank you. Actually, I'll update the follower count right now. So I don't have it like automated or anything, but here we go. 582. There we go, there we go, there we go. Only like a little under 2,000 now to the follower goal. Let's go. Also, let me close out of Discord. I didn't even realize I still had this open. Yeah, definitely let me close out of that. But okay. Impermanent Assault effect when they dump four to try to go summon out Ogier. And now they have Rizehart in hand. We don't know the other three cards, but we need to play through Nib. Yep, need to play through Nib. And set up, Interruption at least. Or maybe we get hit with Nib and then we don't set up any interruption. No, it wouldn't work because they have Saranma. So they could go like, yeah, they could go Muckraker and then discard summon Saranma, reset Rakea, pop Rakea, play from there under the Muckraker anyways. Yeah, so it wouldn't work. All right, fair enough. So we have to set up interruptions, no choice. Hey, shout out to Leftover Shark for the gifting of the sub to Tomic102. I appreciate you. Thank you. And now we're at 46 subscribers. Let's go. Let's go. Thank you, Leftover Shark. I appreciate you. Whenever someone brings up leftovers, I'm not even kidding. I do think of Leftover Shark. I do be thinking of Leftover Shark. I actually thought about you when I was at YCS Indy. 'Cause I'd eaten a bunch of food and I had to get like two little like leftover things. And I thought about Leftover Shark. Nah, not sus, not sus, not sus, not sus, not sus, not sus, not sus. But I do think about Leftover Shark. I don't know why, your name's just like in my brain. Like whenever I think of leftovers, I'm like, yeah, dude, Leftover Shark. It's like I don't know why those are like connected, but I think it's funny. What are these tags? VTuber e-girl. Hey, the VTuber e-girl tags, people bring this up a lot, but they really do get me a bunch of views for no reason. Like, literally just having those down there has gotten me like I don't even remember how much now, but I know before it was like 500 or something like that off of just the VTuber thing. Like, yeah, I'll put VTuber e-girl down in my tags if that's gonna get me more views and stuff, right? I mean, I am a VTuber. This isn't even me. This is a VTuber right now. Like, could a real person do this? Exactly. Can't just take your eyeballs out. Nah, imagine though. Imagine I just do that. Take my eyes out. I'm actually an AI the whole time, not a real person. That'd be insane. That'd be insane. 4 years straight of AI. That's interesting, DBG. DB Grinder be thinking about Leftover Shark whenever he eats his leftover fish sticks. Oh, God, no. You can't eat fish sticks leftover. I mean, you probably could, but I feel like if you're making fish sticks, you kind of just like eat them right away, right? But a bunch of views from people searching for the actual thing. I don't think it's because they're searching for it. I just think it kind of pops up. Like, it probably works like if you watch a bunch of streamers who have like VTuber and e-girl as their tags, and let's say you happen to watch a bunch of Yu-Gi-Oh! Master Duel streamers who have that, then you might end up showing, then they might end up showing my stream to you because I'm also a Master Duel VTuber e-girl. So I'm pretty sure that's how it works. Pretty sure. But most VTubers can read big words. Yeah, but most VTubers are stupid. Yeah, how do you feel about that one? Yeah. Maybe reading big words makes you dumb. I don't know. Who's to say I'm not right? Who's to say I'm not right? Who's to say that 200 IQ is smart? Maybe 200 IQ is dumb. Maybe zero IQ is smart. See? These are the real questions that you have to ask the world. How much money do you make off YouTube? At least $1. Do we know the other deck? Yeah, it's Unchained. Unchained 1, Game 1. Activate Phoenix Blade, Snake Eyes, Send. They don't even have the Ricardito in deck anymore, though, which kind of sucks, because that'd be pretty good. But they can bring out Fire Flint Lady, Angelica, Museum, Surge. We haven't used Durendal this turn. Would we even go for Durendal? We have Museum Summon. So much. I can't believe chat said that this deck was bad earlier. This deck's not a bad deck. Come on now. Look at this. The Revenge. Now we're playing through Hand Trap plus Nib. You know, our deck, like Infernoble, can't do it as well as that deck was able to do at that time. But that's also, I don't know, I mean, it's also fair, right? Imperm Nib's crazy. Most VTubers have big titties, though. Yeah, alright. You got me at that one. Facts. Average American IQ. Average. That tier list just lost to Branded Puppet Lock, by the way. Yeah. Branded Puppet. Nah, I mean, it was fair enough. It happens to anyone. Fun fact. Albania has the lowest average IQ in Europe. Albania. Crazy enough. Fun fact, Albania is a real place, because I never knew that until right now. That's actually a place, Albania. I thought that was like a One Piece city, but it's good if you're good at rock, paper, scissors. Oh, a capybara emote, god yes. Did that hand play through Imperm the connector? Yeah, for sure. Okay, Phoenix Blade on Angelica, dump, summon. It's dump OG or now, right? I'm almost certain. Well, I guess there's Turpin. Let me think. Do we need the Turpin body later? Well, no, we just go for OG anyways, right? Because OG brings out Turpin. Yeah, OG dumps Turpin anyways. Oh, we dump Gearfried. Oh, okay. Go for Gearfried. Sure. Is a country. Come to Brazil, DB Grinder. One day. That's where I want to go. That's like the only place I actually want to travel to a Yu-Gi-Oh! Event now. Is like Brazil. Or I guess like Mexico and stuff like that would be cool too. But I'd rather go to Brazil. Especially because y'all actually have capybaras, like walking around, like that just sounds like a great time for me. That sounds like a great time. You're just walking around. There's just capybaras chilling. You're just like, I don't know. Especially because like everyone that, I don't know if it's for Brazil or probably different parts of Brazil different. But I've been told that like a lot of like the South American events are like super cheap, like super super cheap for like an American, which sounds sick. Sounds like my kind of place. Capybaras cheap. I mean, come on now. I think it's like the same time zone too, or relatively close to the same time zone that I'm in, which helps because like going to Germany, like, the time zone changed, like, infinite hours, which just made it so much harder to do anything. Well, not do anything. I mean, my sleep schedule ended up getting fixed, but, like, I was just, like, more tired because I, you know, 6-hour difference in the sleep schedule. Brother, I know people from Albania are very nice people. Fair enough. I bet you they are very nice people. I just don't know the country. Didn't know it. Nothing cheap about traveling to Latin. Well, traveling there, no. Travel as in like the flight, no. But there's no shot. There's no shot. They forgot. Yeah, they forgot about Abominable summoning itself if they pop Nib. So they pop Nib, Abominable summoned itself, Abominable popped Emperor Charles, and that's literally game. They also put the Rekia in grave for the Saranma in hand. They fumbled that a little bit there, I'm not gonna lie. It wouldn't have been the easiest game to win anyways, but like that was a little bit of a fumble. Wow. Okay. Okay, let me go ahead and dish out the points. I go prediction who will win. You know, 75% voted Matrix, and Matrix did win. Matrix is moving on to the finals. Said I have to go anyways. Ha ha ha. Fair enough. Said where are you from? Me? Or them? I was gonna say I'm from America, United States. Okay, so we are in game 3. I would say, the player with Griffin face up on their field against the branded player is probably in the winning spot right now. Doesn't seem like there was an imperm or anything that stopped it, so this is still live. Oh, and this is Synchro Bestial branded too. That's interesting. But, okay, yeah, so we only had 6.5k points gambled on top 4. I want to see at least 10k points gambled on the finals, gosh darn it. Also, shout out to Bruce Leas for the follow. Shout out to Grizzly Lock for the follow. Thank you. You should have been on Brandon Camara. Would have won for sure. Who? Oh, this player? This player? And face search Brandon White. Cartesia try to add back. I mean, I just don't see how any of this is like ever beating Griffin. Right? Like this card just stays and like next turn this deck gets infinite pluses. Like actually infinite pluses. This deck still plays Unicorn, right? Yeah, actually, you have to. It's not even a choice. It's not even a choice. You probably play Unicorn with SP now. I don't know what you'd cut from the extra deck, though, for the SP. But I imagine that Unicorn has to be there. It would come up so much when you're trying to break boards to be able to, like... Because you get Fiend Locked off these. So it'd come up a lot. But also, I wonder if you even play... You probably don't even play, Sky Crisis, the extra deck's tight. I'm still ready to smoke on some good stuff later. Okay, wish I didn't read that. Definitely thought that it said you were gonna smoke on tier. Would have won for sure. Yes, this player will. Can I get a free Arise Heart? Oh God, no, do not free Arise Heart. We are not freeing Arise Heart. Don't say that. Let it go. Let it go. It's gone. The extra deck was tight enough that you sided Mannequin before. Don't want to know what it's like now. Guess you could cut a bomb. Yeah. Like before, yeah, that's what I was saying. Like before it was tough. But now, it'd be even more tough. With there just being so many more good stuff being out. Free him, bro. Please. Free both. Free Kit. No, we're not freeing Kit. Gosh darn it. Kit is staying banned. That one is not coming back. Maybe one day, but like, why? Why bring back Kit? Don't do it. Free Circular, he did nothing wrong. Free Harp. Yeah, honestly, if we were bringing back like any of that stuff, we may as well bring back Harp. Because that card would probably make for like the coolest gameplay. Like, it'd work with the Horus cards and stuff like that, so it'd make for cool gameplay. Free LP, stop. Cut the twins, they're overrated. What? Nah, the evil twin, live twin stuff is the best part of this deck. I'm not gonna lie, it's not the sprites, it's the evil twin, live twin stuff. Like, for all this deck together, like, if I had to choose to stop any of the cards, I would choose to stop the Evil Twin. I would actually choose to stop the Evil Twins over the Runic cards. So I think the Evil Twin cards are better in this deck than the Runic cards. But sometimes the Runic cards do just go crazy and they went off of it. It do be like that. Sometimes they just draw a bunch of Runic cards off Fountain and the game gets to a grind game and they keep drawing a bunch of Runic cards off Fountain. But you'll have those. It is what it is. Meow. True Wiser Card ban. Nah, Prank Kids can stay hit. They can stay hit. It's like a one card combo deck. Free Harp so I can play Dino Orcist. Skill issue. Brain issue. Yes, let me link it off for Striker and Banish the Rebellion. Y'all can have a Rise Heart back if I can get Masterpiece. Stop. God, Masterpiece actually can't ever come back just because there's gonna be so many people that play it. It's gonna be like before where there were only people that played True Draco and never switched off of it no matter the format. They would just change their floodgates up and be like, okay, cool, this works. God, I hope that ever happens again. Meow can never be unbanned. That card is so dumb. Yeah, 100%, 100%. That card should not be unbanned. It should stay banned. I don't think the deck's, like, overly broken or anything. I just don't think it should come back. Terra Top to 2-3, please. Need it for my PK deck. I wish we could actually put Terra Top up more. Give Speedroids a boost. That deck needs the boost. Gosh, look at this. They got all the Link 4s on their field. It's like, it's so hard to lose if you get to this point. Cartesia, Albaz in hand, and Branded in white. Yep, but they are unable to actually attack for game as their deck has used a runic spell the last turn. But on this next turn, we might not have to use a runic spell. End phase, a bomb to go pop. I'm guessing that this Quem was normaled? Actually, no. Okay, they're trying to Rinbrum summon itself out. Okay. This was definitely special. Yeah, that was definitely special, not normaled. Nah, give me my cat back. I can be trusted. Chill. Yeah, it'd be fun for Vanquish Soul. What? Oh, that actually would be kind of cool. Prank Kid Vanquish Soul. Just open stake your soul. Just have to. You have to open stake your soul. But if it popped off, it'd be broken. Bear just normal summon deck is dead. Just pop. Well, I mean, sure, yeah. But I'm just saying it shouldn't come back. Just because it's easy to beat doesn't mean it should come back. Bro, give me Electromite. TCG Pendulums legit can't perform some combos because it's banned. That's good. Electromite should stay banned. Actually, I argue we should ban more Pendulum cards. I hate Dice Roll decks. I hate them so much. Like Dark World? My god. Dark World and Pendulum arguably should be hit more than Unchained and Rescue Ace. That's just my opinion. Because those decks are... They literally... have to go first. That's how it feels at least. Unban a Rise Heart, bro, hear me out. We can be trusting with VFD. L take. What did Pendulum do wrong? They just go first and they just set up big combo that you can't break. And they're obviously playing through hand traps because they don't play any hand traps. You look at your hand and you're like, oh, it's 5 engine cards. Nice. I'm playing through an Ash Blossom, of course. Any deck that just aims to win turn 1 should get hit. The new Zark stuff is so cringe. I don't even know what that new stuff is. Fire Truck Healthy Chat. When we have an Edison tournament. I actually thought about that. I saw an Edison tournament as I like hosted this one. I thought about hosting Edison, but Edison... You know, people don't care about Edison as much as, like, current format. Maybe I'll host an Edison tournament one day. For sure, one day. Oh, God, yes. All of my friend Pearlies. My My personal favorite is every time there is a new Pendulum card, people come out and say we're sleeping on pens because they can make a broken turn one board. Yep. Every single time, people are like, oh my gosh, look at this turn one end board. It's 15 interruptions. It's a two-card combo. It's like, okay, cool. We could do that in 2017, 2018. That's not the problem. Gosh. Hate Pendulum. This just doesn't do anything. It's so crazy how good Nightmare Griffin is versus Branded. It's actually just like, it's not real. It's not real. Yeah, bring out, draw, pop. Do they have Opening Engrave? They don't have Opening Engrave, okay. Oh, look at that. All three drool next to each other. Okay, so what are they popping? Because none of the Branded player's monsters can activate their effects because of Griffin, besides their graveyard effects. So they want a Mirror Jade. Yeah, that's what they want to do. They want a Mirror Jade to pop, but they have Muckraker anyways. But what? That wasn't made with anything, though. Oh, that wasn't made with IP. That's true. That was not made with IP. So, that would not be able to protect the field. So, Mirror Jade trying to go in here. Do we have, like, a Runic Slumber to prevent this for the time being? Because I'm assuming they just crash Mirror Jade into a bomb. Pen one card FTK chat. The new pen support is kind of cute. Works as an independent strategy with normal summon or normal engine staple ratios rather than the usual pendulum garbage pile. Oh yeah, see, I like stuff like that. Like the Draco Slayer deck. That deck seemed cool for a while. I think it had room for like 9 non-engine spots. And they used Fenrir as one of them right when it came out. Because like Fenrir gave the deck a discard and a body on field. I don't know, that deck was cool. How is this game still going on? There's still a game here, to be fair. There's still a game here. Like, they're outing the field, right? Like, Mirror Jade is outing the field here, unless if they have, like, Runic Slumber to stop it or something. Okay, so Abomination, Pomp Albion, the Shrouded Dragon. But we also do have to think. Time could come up. And we are only about 7 minutes until time. So the players do need to think about that, because this player has the advantage. Also, what game is this? It's game 3, okay. Game 3. Activate Runic Tip. Sheesh! Make him banish Sornir, go grab Slumber. Is it thinking here? No way you're about the fountain first, right? I'm about to say, yeah, no way you're about the fountain for one. I feel like you want a fountain for multiple. Okay, so now they're going to go Slumber on the Muckraker. That's fine. Yeah. Twin Twister sounds crazy. But banish Twin Twisters from their deck. This player has not been having a good time versus Flounderies. I just had two Subway ads play back-to-back. The fix is in. Oh god, yes. Sandwiches are so broken. God, yes. I love sandwiches. Anyone that ever tells you they don't like sandwiches, I want you to never talk to that person again. That's advice from DBG right here, straight from the source. I'm being straight up about that. They don't like sandwiches, you don't like them, alright? Straight up. People just need to learn to deck build better instead of copying standard lists. I'll say true to that. But also, I would say, some people need to learn how to use a standard list. Some people need to stop cooking. Sometimes, you cook so far that you have literally burnt the meal. And you have fumbled. You fumbled bad. Oh my god, I'll never forget. There was one time, it was me and Walter. It was like a day before YCS Niagara 2022. Me and him both had not too much testing for the event, And we want, well, we had testing, but not too much. And we wanted to test a bunch. But DB was down for like 4 days before that YCS. It had gone up, like, boom, like one day before. We tried cooking so hard. It was so bad. It was the worst thing. It was so bad. Actually, the worst deck I've ever taken to an event. And we played tier branded with the Scythe combo in the main deck. Not good. But right there, that would have been a very good time for me to take a very standard list instead of what I showed up with. But that will never happen again, so it's fine. I don't think these are the correct life points, right? Like, technically, this is Ganging. Okay. Linking off in the SP. Maybe Dark Charmer. No, SP. Okay. Quem SP. Yeah, I mean, the Sunny Snitch seems like it's going to win the game. There's under 4 minutes left at this point. So Branded has to just play fast. Branded has to play fast. That's really it. Yep. They need to play fast. They have to play faster than what they're playing now. Like, an extreme pace of speed. Like, unbelievable. Because the opponent can take so much time with their deck. Depending on what they have. Yeah, we're gonna go ahead, add back. Oh, jeez. They added back so many things at once, and I was clicked on the graveyard that it messed up, but there we go. Okay. 3 minutes left. They already used Quem to Reborn that turn. I'm going to assume that they didn't. Because I didn't check log. What, did they summon out the Shrouded Dragon? There we go. I'll ask, just because chat brought it up. But I don't know if they did or not. I actually don't remember. Yeah. Because they didn't summon that from hand. Nice catch. Okay, there we go. So go ahead, put those back. Twin just stall spams, no? Yep. That's all they're gonna try to do, at least. But it looks like it's gonna work. Yeah. Doesn't matter, I was losing the second I was paired versus this deck. I have a 0% win rate against it. On God. That's crazy. On God. What a response. On God. Not against Matrix in the finals, please. Oh. It is. Good luck. Alright, and then I already did the predictions for that round, right? Okay, so predictions for the finals now. The finals. Who will win? We got Matrix versus Denker.